Namaste. Okay, today's topic is writing a description of a place. We are in Unit 10, almost at the end of Unit 10. So in today's class, we are going to do writing, the last section of this unit. And under this section, we are going to do how to write a description of a place. This is simply like an essay or essay writing. So before we begin, let me talk about how we write an essay. We collect, before we write an essay in the exam, we have no time to say collect information or make outlines or say guidelines in the beginning and then write. We don't have time in the examination hall, but for now, we have enough time. That's why what we need to do is we need to collect information and then we prepare an outline. By being based on the outline or information we have picked up or we have collected, we compose an essay or we compose any sort of writing. So that helps us to make our writing, you know, systematic and better. So without any delay, let me start today's topic. In Unit 10, while writing a description of a place, in your textbook on page number 117, it is given. So let me show you here. In the textbook, it is given before you write, in number A, before you write section, go through the guidelines below and prepare your outline to write a description of a place, it says. And we are given almost four boxes there, and these four boxes mean we have to compose four paragraphs in our writing. It means while writing an essay, there might be more than four paragraphs, but for our practice here, our book has given some guidelines, and at least we have to compose four paragraphs. That makes our writing good. And for the examination viewpoint also, you know, we don't have much time to write more paragraphs or because of time limitation and because of, say, marks weightage. So that's why let's read and understand what are given in the textbook first. It says in the first box, while describing a place, you have to give introduction. Say, introduction, your destination. So this means we have to give introduction to the place, to your place. Your place means on which place you are going to write an essay. So, so while giving introduction, you don't have to forget to give the location. Where is it? Where is it means location. In which district or in what place? And then next one is how do we reach there? Means how is the place accessible? How can we reach there? By foot? On foot or say by any vehicles or is there any transportation or not? Or how far is it? We have to give some details of your place. And in the second paragraph, this is called body paragraph number one. In paragraph number one, we simply try to give introduction. And in the second paragraph, that is our body paragraph, first body paragraph. So it is purpose of the visit. We have to describe what purpose is there behind your visit. See, purpose of the visit means here, religious significance, natural sites, or you have to, you can describe historical significance or personal interest. Religious significance, if it is a religious place, you can describe how the purpose of your visit, or if people like to visit that place, what can be the purpose? Religious purpose might be sometimes. Sometimes it is just because of natural beauties. So there is written this, you know, natural sites. And after that, we have historical significance, personal interest also. Sometimes, you know, people visit that place or people can go to that place because of their own personal interest. So you don't have to forget those information there. And in body paragraph number two, you have to give more detail like your findings or observation. What do you see there, or what do you hear, or taste, or smell, and feel? It means overall observation you have to describe. What do you find there? That kind of details or information should be included in body paragraph number 2. And lastly, we give conclusion. So this is conclusion section. Why should people visit this place? You have to give a very short information, or say you need to write short writing, short sentences there, which will highlight why people should visit this place. So these are the 4 steps. If you have more things to write, you can write 5 or 6 paragraphs as well. But our textbook gives a guideline that we have to be limited within this and compose, or you can form an essay or a writing. So let me show you how I have prepared my own by being based on those guidelines. Look at this. In the first box, according to the first box in introduction section, I'm going to write about Gosai Kunda. And that's why, while writing about Gosai Kunda, I have tried my best to give introduction like this. What is Gosai Kunda, or what is it? If people ask, then there is information. Freshwater lake, the best trekking destination. And in the second point, located in Langtang National Park at an altitude of 4,380 meters in Rasuwa. It means this is the location. And third information I have tried to include here is 6 to 7 hour drive to Dhunche from Kathmandu, then 2 days long steady climb from there. Hotels, shelters available. It means there are some other more information also. Let's see, later on we will try to include these things in the first paragraph while giving introduction to Gosai Kunda. And likewise, in our first body paragraph, it means in our second paragraph of our writing of our essay, let's say body paragraph number 1, purpose of the visit. What purpose of the visit? Let's say, while writing about Gosai Kunda, religious significance is there, certainly. Hindu myth and holy bathing, or this is holy bathing. It means there is Hindu mythology, or there is a story connected to Hindu religion about Gosai Kunda, about its origin, and then about holy bathing also. Then natural sites, means beautiful sites, beautiful places are there, no wonder. Then natural sites are like scenic beauty of Himalayas, forest, alpine lakes, flora and fauna, means animals and plants, ethnic communities, it means local people there, like Sherpas and Tamangs, you know. So personal interest, because of personal interest also, like trekking and adventure. Look at this. So these things I have tried to include in paragraph number 2. This means body paragraph number 1. Now body paragraph number 2, your findings or observation. It means I have tried to include these things in my observation, like we can have beautiful view of Ganesh Himal, Langtang, this is also another name of mountain, Manaslu Range, Hyuchuli and Tibetan Peak. These are major highlights, major names of mountains you can see over there. And see, mesmerizing slopes, lakes, forest are there, flowers are there, like rhododendrons, bamboo bushes, you know. And then yak pasture. Yak pasture means the ground, the place where yaks, you know, graze. And pilgrims. There are flocks of pilgrims there. So these are some information I have tried to include in paragraph number 2. Now, similarly, paragraph number 4, last paragraph will be conclusion. A must visit place for nature lovers and adventurers. This is my suggestion. This is my suggestion to the other people to visit this place. Who can visit this place, or why people should visit this place? This has been included in last paragraph. Now, after this, we have time for writing. So, in time for writing, we are going to write. We are going to read one sample writing we are given there in our textbook. And then after that, we'll move on to how we compose, how we write, or how we produce a writing being based on the information we have tried to include or we have tried to write just now. So for reading one sample of, you know, Devgard, let's check it out again. It is in your textbook on page number 117. You can see there. Read the description of Devgard and write a similar type of description of the place you are familiar with based on the information that you have collected in exercise A. First, read this and then we'll move on to our own writing. So, let's begin. It begins like this. Have you ever been to Devgard? Means, have you gone to Devgard? It is one of the sacred places of the Hindus. It means it's a very holy place, religious place of the Hindus. This confluence of Kali Gandaki and Trishuli means this is the place where Kali Gandaki and Trishuli river, two big rivers meet. Confluence means meeting place of two rivers. So this confluence of Kali Gandaki and Trishuli river is believed to be one of the holiest places in Hindu mythology. Devgad lies in Tanahu district. Look at the introduction. Where is it? Where is Devgad? Devgad is in Tanahu district. It is about 7 kilometers far from the city of Narayanagarh. Means this information is given there describing how we can reach that place. Look at this. It is about 7 kilometers far from the city of Narayanagarh. You can hire a taxi from the city or you can also get a public bus from Pokhara bus park to go to Devgad. Look at this. People visit this sacred place for various reasons. Means there are many reasons why people visit this place. And did you get in the introductory paragraph what kind of information has been included? Surely, I hope so. There is description of the location as well as accessibility, means how we can reach that place. How can we get to that place? Now, second paragraph runs like this. Many pilgrims like to reach Devgad. Some of them go there to take a holy bath. Others go to collect a Shaligram Shila, holy stone, you know. The Hindu people use this, worship this stone, black colored stone mostly, which Hindu devotees worship as Lord Vishnu. This stone, Shaligram, is worshipped as Lord Vishnu by Hindu people. Now, a few Hindus or elderly Nepalese live out their final years of their life there. Means Devgad is the place where old people take shelters or spend their lives. Means there are many ashrams. This is a Nepali word, you might have understood this. There are many ashrams which are built to give shelters to such elderly people. Means old-aged people, you know, old people, elderly people pass their final years, you know, there in ashrams. So you can spend their nights in the, people can spend their nights in the ashrams too. So this is what? This is about Devgad, giving all the information about religious significance. Why people go to Devgad? Because of its religious importance. They go there to take holy bath. This is given there. So the second paragraph is the first body paragraph of this essay. Now let's check out next the second body paragraph, that is the third paragraph of our writing in the textbook. The atmosphere of Devgad is peaceful and contemplative. Keep in mind that in this paragraph, you know, the information is like your findings and observation included in this paragraph. The atmosphere of Devgad is peaceful and contemplative. Contemplative is like peaceful, meditative. The chanting and prayers around the temples soothes everyone who visits there. Means the songs, religious songs, chantings, prayers there in that area, you know, that helps to make your mind peaceful, that pacify your mind, makes your mind cool, peaceful. Ashrams, temples, caves, and the confluence are the major tourist attractions. Major tourist attractions are ashrams, temples, caves and the confluence. See, these are the major places that you can visit there. Various religious activities are performed there throughout the year. Most importantly, on the first day of Nepali month of Magh, that falls in mid-January, thousands of pilgrims flock to take a holy bath in the confluence. Means many religious people come there to Devghat to take holy bath. When? When? On the first day of Nepali month, Magh. Temples like Radha Krishna temple and Hanuman temple, caves like Sita Gufa and Vasishta Gufa are must visit places. Means other important places are there, like Sita Gufa, Vasishta Gufa, Hanuman temple is there and Radha Krishna temple is there. The best way to experience Devghat is to wander around, means to move around the gravel streets, cross the river in a boat or via suspension footbridge high over the rushing water of the Trishuli. Means there is a suspension bridge over the river Trishuli. You can cross the river there. On both sides, you know, there is Mela. You can see, you can enjoy the Mela there. Or you can cross the boat also, cross the river in a boat. Visit infinite number of the ashrams. There are many number of, infinite number means unlimited, many numbers of the ashrams. Observe Melas and listen to the heart-touching life stories of elderly people. Not only pilgrims, people like researchers, nature lovers, saints, wanderers and adventure seekers go there. It means apart from the religious people or pilgrims, other people like researchers also can go there. Researchers can go there, and then like saints, wanderers, adventure seekers means the people who love adventure, who like doing difficult tasks or say risky kind of things they like to do. They can also visit this place. So this is the body paragraph number 2, and the last concluding paragraph is there. Devghat is a must visit place for those who respect the elderly people and for those who like to help them. See, it means in the last paragraph, why people should visit Devghat is given. This means this is a conclusive paragraph. So like this, this is just a model. This is just a model writing, a sample writing. Follow this or follow the steps given in your textbook or in your model writing, and then you have to compose your own. And for you, let me show you, based on this information that we have, I have shown you, like I have tried to collect the information about Gosai Kunda from my own experience as well. So this, being based on this information or these outlines, let me show you how an essay has been composed. It begins from here. Gosai Kunda, this is another essay, or this is our own writing. Gosai Kunda, you might have heard about this place. And if you have not heard, then you will hear here, you will hear it right in this essay. Or most of the people in Nepal might have heard about Gosai Kunda. This is a very famous religious place, and not only from religious viewpoint, this place is famous for trekking also. Let's see, Gosai Kunda. What we have to include in the first paragraph? Keep in mind, we have to include its location, where is it, and then how do we reach there. Mostly, these are the basic things we have to include in the first paragraph while giving introduction. Look at this, look at the introduction. This is first paragraph introduction, but we don't have to write a topic like introduction. See, just write down the paragraph smoothly. I have begun the essay with the same sentence from your textbook. Look at this. Have you ever been to Gosai Kunda? It is not necessary. It is not compulsory to write, to begin your essay with this. You can begin from any sentence, just giving information about Gosai Kunda. But I have copied this one from the book. Have you ever been to Gosai Kunda? Known for its spectacular and breathtaking scenic beauty, Gosai Kunda is one of the best trekking destinations in the world. What did you get? Did you hear anything? What is Gosai Kunda known for? Or what is Gosai Kunda famous for? It is given there. Known for its spectacular and breathtaking. Spectacular means very beautiful. It means impressive, spectacular, beautiful. Spectacular and breathtaking also, you know, they are similar words. Scenic beauty means Gosai Kunda is famous for its beauty. It means it is a naturally beautiful place. Gosai Kunda is one of the best trekking destination in the world. Did you hear that? Gosai Kunda is one of the best trekking destinations in the world, not only in Nepal. Undoubtedly, means without doubt, it is regarded sacred place for shamans, or we can say, shamans means here, spiritualist. Spiritualist means those people whose souls or whose spirits may make contact with evil or bad, good or bad type of spirits. Means they can talk to bad spirits or sometimes good spirits. So they are shamans. The traditional witch doctors, Dhami Jhakri we call it in Nepali, Dhami Jhakri, witch doctors, as well as for both Hindus and Buddhists. It means what kind of people visit that place? All types of spiritualists, say witch doctors, Dhami Jhakris, that means, and then all Hindus or Buddhists, all religious people. Gosai Kunda is an alpine freshwater lake in Nepal's Langdang National Park. It means Gosai Kunda is a freshwater lake, alpine lake in Nepal's Langtang National Park, located at an altitude means it's the height of 4,380 meters in Roswa district. Did you get the information? First information, or very important information. Where is this place? Where is Gosai Kunda? This comes in this line. It is in Roswa district. It is at the height of 4,380 meters, and it is in Langtang National Park in Roswa. Now, next, the overflow of the lake forms the Trishuli River. Another important information. The Trishuli River, a famous river in Nepal, originates from this lake, begins from this lake. To reach the place, now, how we can get there? How can we reach this place? This is given in the next lines. Look at this. To reach the place, it's 6 to 7 hour drive from Kathmandu to Dhunche, and from there it is at least 2 days steady climb, continuous climb along the trail of the mountain which winds around dense forest of rhododendron. Means what kind of way, what kind of trail, what kind of path? The path is up the mountain. That winds means that goes like a snake, you know, curling, moving side to side. There are different bends or winding road, you know, winding path, not road in fact. So winds around dense forest of rhododendron. There is forest of rhododendron, oak. Oak is another name of trees that are found in the high mountains. Bamboo, we call it Ningalo in Nepali. So bamboo and bas, that's the same family. And beautiful settlement of Tamang and Sherpa means there are some villages, tiny villages of Tamang and Sherpa people, ultimately leading us to the divine lake of Gosai Kunda. Lastly, we reach Gosai Kunda from there. Trekkers can also choose the trekking route from Sundarijal. Alternatively, they can, you know, if you are the trekkers, you can go there from Sundarijal, from Kathmandu, you know, or from Shabrubeshi, Raswa, near, you know, say, Gadeshimal. So people visit this place for various reasons. Since why people visit there, it will be given in the next paragraph. Let's check out. Here, the next paragraph, this means the first body paragraph begins like this. Gosai Kunda means it is the significance of Gosai Kunda, this place. Significance. What is religious significance, or are there any natural sites or not? Let's try to check it. Gosai Kunda is regarded as a religious site. It means it's a religious place. Hindu mythology, where is it? Hindu mythology attributes Gosai Kunda as the abode of the Hindu deities Shiva and Gauri. It means this is the home of Lord Shiva and Gauri, according to the Hindu mythology. Mythology is old, you know, religious stories, remember. The Hindu scriptures, means Hindu books, religious books like Bhagavad Puran, Vishnu Purana and the epics Ramayana and Mahabharata refer to Samudra Manthan, which is directly related to the origin of Gosaikunda. It means there are stories about Samudra Manthan in those religious books, and that talks about what? That talks about how Gosaikunda originated. So it is believed to have been created by Lord Shiva during Samudra Manthan, when he thrust his trishul into a mountain to extract water so that he could cool his stinging throat after he had swallowed poison. In the story of Samudra Manthan, you know, there is a story. Lord Shiva swallowed poison, and because of that, you know, it gave a terrible pain in his throat, and to satisfy or to cool his throat, stinging throat, he just wanted to drink water. As there was no water, with his powerful trishul, you know, strong trishul, he thrust it in the mountain, and then there came the water out through the three holes made by the trishul. And even today, you can see water coming out of three holes, you know, from that mountain, just behind that lake. Now here, next, its water is considered holy and of particular significance during the Ganga Dasara and the Janai Purnima festivals. Means these are the two names of festivals, like Janai Purnima and Ganga Dasara, where most of people, religious people, go there, visit this place, when thousands of pilgrims from Nepal and India visit the area. It is believed that once you bathe in this holy lake, all your pains, sorrows and sins will be washed off. Look at it, how important this place is. Apart from its religious importance, trekkers visit here because of the beauty and adventure it serves. I have already told you, not only from religious viewpoint, from because of its natural beauty also, people visit this place, and for those adventure lovers, it is a must visit place. It grants the chance to the trekkers and adventure admirers, lovers, to explore the land that is far behind the time, and offers perfectly placed terraced slopes, settlement of ethnic groups, rare wild animals, and diverse range of flora and fauna. It means different types of animals and plants can be seen, and that's why this place is important. And now let's check out the second body paragraph. In this paragraph, we will try to include our findings or observation, what we can see or taste or feel, you know, your experience you have to include here. Look at this, how it begins. Visitors can't stop loving this place. It means they love this place, surely. They are mesmerized by the alpine yak pasture, the mountain panorama, and beautiful freshwater lakes. Mountain panorama is the beautiful view of mountain, that is panorama, view, sights, say, vista. There are 108 lakes in this area, small to medium in size, which remain frozen for 6 months in winter season. Look at this, 108 seasons, namely, you know, Bhairav Kunda or Saraswati Kunda, there are different lakes there in this area. Taking a bath in the cold water of Gosai Kunda helps you to remove fatigue, means tiredness, and refresh your mind. Similarly, Ganesh Himal, Langtang, and Manaslu Range, Himchuli, and Tibetan Peak are some of the major highlights of the adventure, means these are the most important places to visit. Gosai Kunda is the best destination not only for pilgrims, not only for religious people, but also for researchers, nature lovers, trekkers, and adventure seekers. This is the end of the second body paragraph. Now comes the last paragraph. It's the conclusion. Gosai Kunda is a must-visit place for those who love nature and adventure. It means why people should visit this place? It's because of its natural beauty, and because of a difficult trekking route. So there is much adventure there. That's why people should visit this place. And this is how we produced a writing, being based on the information we have collected. Now, for you, we have some other more follow-up activity. And here in follow-up activity, you see, we are asked to write a descriptive paragraph about the person who has great influence in your life. You have already read about Yogamaya in this unit. And that's why I think you can write about any other famous people, famous person you are inspired or influenced by. And that's why this is up to you. Don't write many paragraphs here. It has asked us to write only one paragraph here, or descriptive paragraph, it says. Describe that person who has great influence in your life. This is up to you. You can describe, you can write it, and show it to your subject teacher. Now here another, project work. We have project work here. So in our project work, we are given one table there, and we have to fill the information. So collect information about the popular places of your district. It means similar to what we did earlier. We have to collect information about any famous or popular place in your district, in your area. Just do it. Fill the table with the relevant information and write an essay based on the information that has been collected. What do we do? Just collect the information like this. This is just one example. Example, tourist destination, Bhaktapur Darbar Square. And location, where is it? It is in Bhaktapur. Significance, what is it important for? Bhaktapur is important for what? Historical and cultural heritage. See, historical and cultural heritage, site, it says site. And route means the way to reach this place from any part of the valley. And region of travel, why we should visit Bhaktapur. It's all about like this, all seasons. Seasons. Seasons of travel means at what time we should visit Bhaktapur. This is all season, and in any season we can visit. So please, dear students, collect the information of any famous or popular place from your district or from your surroundings, and then collect this information first. Make an outline, and then prepare writing, compose an essay about that particular place. Now, lastly, before we leave, there is one fun corner. Read and enjoy the following tongue twisters. Say them as fast as you can. This is just for your enjoyment. How difficult it is to make clear pronunciation. Look at this. Number A. Can. Just practice this. This helps you to improve your pronunciation, to make your pronunciation clear. Number B is there. I wish to wish the wish you used to wish. Look at this. Number C is there. I scream, you scream, we all scream for ice cream. Now number D, six slimy snails sailed silently. Six slimy snails sailed silently. It's really tongue twisters, you know, difficult to pronounce. Please practice more. And don't forget to write essay about the place, famous popular place from your district, and get your copies checked by your subject teacher. I think your subject teacher will definitely help you. And this brings us to the end of this lesson, this unit. And till then, have a wonderful day. Namaste.